to this week's episode of Everybody Eats. My name is Bruce.
I'm Cheese.
And this week we went to B&K Smokehouse. B&K Smokehouse is a fish and chicken rib.
Did they even have fish?
They probably didn't have fish.
It's a barbecue.
Barbecue spot. I'm sorry.
All right, man, whatever. We gonna let that ride.
Nah, I'm not. Actually, I'm gonna do that over.
Nah.
No?
Nah, it's too late.
Damn.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's a barbecue spot located in the Olde Towne East area. It's fairly, actually it's right across the street from Feed Me Sandwich Kings, which we also did a few weeks ago.
Yep.
So there's that. It's kind of small, probably can sit about, 15 people, if that.
I don't even know if they have 15 chairs in there, honestly.
Yeah, it's mainly a carryout spot, so there's not a lot of seating.
A bunch of art and whatever.
It was art, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's pretty cool in there for sure. Pictures and a big flag that says beef or something.
I
took a picture of it. Barbecue, I'm sorry. Something like, yeah.
Oh!
Yeah. Big flag says barbecue.
Ooh. Right. What? Why is that a French flag?
And it is a French flag. So I'll put it on there so y'all can see.
Yeah, what?
So.
Yeah, I didn't notice that at all.
So yeah, so we order our food. They didn't really have like any, you know, house made drinks or anything.
Yeah, no, so. no spirits.
Exactly.
No cocktails.
Yeah, no juice.
Thank God.
No beverages.
Sorry, drink.
So we got our food. I ordered the barbecue ribs with a side of mac and cheese and greens. And it also comes with a side of bread with your choice of wheat, white, or cornbread.
They didn't have the cornbread though.
That day.
Yeah, I think it was just a we ain't got it right now type thing. Mm-hmm. But they didn't have it, so I couldn't get it. Mm. I do enjoy cornbread.
I do enjoy cornbread too.
A lot.
Yeah. I actually went back a few days after we went for this myself.
And you got the cornbread?
I did get the cornbread. I'm sorry. I told you when I was going, when I was leaving, I'm like, hey, I'm going back to that spot.
I didn't want it, bro. It was too late. I already had it.
That's fair. But anyways, the ribs were actually pretty good. The barbecue sauce they used on those, it was kind of like tangy, with like a little bit of smoke flavor in there. I don't know how to describe it. I'm not a rib connoisseur per se. But it was just good, just all around. The meat on the ribs was tender. As far as the size goes, mac and cheese was good. You know, it wasn't like spectacular, but it was good. Greens were pretty good themselves, actually.
Yeah, those greens was going crazy.
Yeah, greens was good for sure.
Great egg greens. I don't know who made them. Shout out to you.
Great egg.
For sure,
For sure. And then the bread, but that's bread, so.
I could, you know, I tasted them greens and I felt my ancestors on my shoulder.
Yeah.
For sure.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I was like, yes, baby, you go ahead and eat that.
It was heartwarming.
Very heartwarming.
I was like, All right, what do you have?
I'm home.
Fuck it.
I had the brisket with macaroni and cheese, baked beans and greens. The brisket dinner is also a side of bread, which I opted for. I don't remember if it was wheat or white. I didn't even eat it, honestly. It was just like literally like some sliced bread. Like it wasn't, but yeah. The brisket was like, it was flavorful. It was almost like it was like ever so slightly like overcooked. It also like, it came with the side of barbecue sauce. They asked me if I wanted just like regular or hot. I guess those were the two options that they had. The hot, I believe, was mustard based. Without the sauce, I would have been very disappointed. With the sauce, I'm like, all right, this is cool. I can do this. But yeah. Also, it was like shredded, and I know like sometimes you go places you get brisket, and it's like they clearly sliced off a piece of the brisket, like the big ass smoked fucking piece of brisket. Yeah, like,
slap.
Yeah, listen, you just get like a slice of it and it's like melts in your mouth. I'm sorry. Sorry, slight erection.
I was saying, like, you good?
Funny
start daydreaming.
Yeah, no. So it was cool. It was all right. Nothing spectacular about it, really. The ribs, though, however, were really good. They were extremely tender. The barbecue sauce was very flavorful. It wasn't like overcooked. It wasn't undercooked. Where I'm like sitting there trying to yank off shit. Yeah, it was just overall a good rib. Mm. Only had one because he a greedy bastard. But
I do love ribs. It's whatever.
It's cool. Piece of shit. the greens were really, really good. Like that was honestly, it's probably some of the best greens I've had, maybe ever, definitely in a long time. Baked beans were good. They were
cinnamon.
It was a lot of cinnamon.
A lot of cinnamon.
It was a lot
for sure.
The first couple bites was like really like kind of off-putting, but as I kept eating it, it kind of I don't know if it just, I guess my palate just got used to it. But initially, this was like
overwhelming.
Like the fucking cinnamon challenge for a second. It was a bit much.
The cinnamon challenge. Wow, that's throwback.
Yeah.
Shit, that's like 2012.
Yeah, it was a cool place. It was good. I'll go back.
The music was good. A lot of the black places that we go to, the music is pretty good.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's just because, I don't know.
They was playing a lot of like just oldies.
Yeah, it probably just reminds us of growing up and cleaning our house or something on Sundays.
Right.
Honestly. But.
Yeah. Service was cool. I mean, it's like your typical like barbecue spot. Or you feel like you're talking to your uncle when they address you. Like,
boy, did I feel like I was talking to my uncle.
Yeah, right. The dude.
Oh, my God.
It was me, him, and Dante. And our friend Dante, for those who don't know. We was there, and when the orders were ready, he's like, what do you say?
He's like, hey, little bro.
Hey, little bro. And he was like,
we all looking at each other like, I don't know.
I guess that's you going.
I don't know if it's he.
And then he went, one of us was going to get it.
Mine.
And then the next order came up, hey, little bro. One of us went up there again. And it was like, he refers to all three of us as little bro. So, shout out to little bro now.
Never forget.
Never forget, little bro.
Little bro now. You can't never forget about little bro now. I'll never forget about
little bro now. Little bro now. So that was funny, but yeah, it just felt like a family like atmosphere
for sure,
to be honest. And then price wise, it was cheap. Oh, excuse me, that's that loud.
That's the H1N1.
Price wise, it was pretty cheap, as you would usually expect from like a black owned, you know, small barbecue spot. So, and, you know, which makes it really worth it because the food tastes great and looks very filling.
For sure.
So, it's great. It gives a lot of great value.
It is. Yeah. I don't even remember how much it was.
I remember it wasn't a lot. I think, like...
It was, like,
you know,
$8, $10 or something. I don't know.
It was, like, $12 for the dinners. Like, yeah. They were, like, $12 to, like, $14 for the chicken dinner, the rib dinner, and the brisket dinner.
Oh yeah, how was the chicken? You got that, like, this man went back.
I went back.
The literal next day. So that tells you that it was probably pretty good.
Yeah, so I went back the next day and I got the chicken dinner where you get 10...
I thought it was 12.
Or 12 wings, I'm sorry. Yeah, 12 wings with two sides.
For $12?
And bread for $12.
Yeah, that's insane.
It's so, yeah, great value. Chicken was really good in my opinion. I did get the cornbread this time because they did have it, and the cornbread was good. But yeah, they were good. So, oh, and to speak back on your brisket, I didn't even talk about that. The brisket was, I'd agree. Like, without the sauce, it was like, it wasn't too...
Like, the flavor's here, but this texture is not really going.
Yeah.
It was a little dry.
It was dry for sure. But once you added that sauce with it, it's like, okay, now it's hitting. All in all, I would give B&K Smokehouse a 3.5. I would say I give it 3.5. The brisket was probably the only thing that like brought it down some, but other than that, I mean, all the other food that I tried was at least decent. Mac and cheese could have been a little bit better as well, but other than that,
could have been a whole lot worse.
Right, exactly, which we've seen before. So. So I definitely, I'll give it a 3.5 out of 4 stars. Yeah.
3.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, that's it.
I liked it. I liked the place.
Yeah. We definitely recommend it for sure.
For sure.
But yeah, thank you guys for watching this week's episode. Hope to see you next time.
I just almost did something really weird. I don't know what just happened. I'm out of here.
Here we are.